Hello guys, today I'm going to talk to you about the Fleet Editor. It's where you design your units to be used in this space RTS. The units in this RTS function like units in any other RTS. You need certain things to unlock them, and then you can just purchase them in-game. The difference is, these units can be customized. Which means you can select a certain ship frame. Certain weapons. And you can add modules in order to give them more shields. Make them shoot down missiles. Make them cheaper to construct. And lots of other options there. So, how should you use the Fleet Editor? Well, like the instruction screen at the beginning said, you first have to select the ship frame, then you select the weaponry. Let's say I'm just going to put plasma cannons in all of the weapon slots on the ship. They're good against heavy targets. And I'm going to name this anti-heavy plasma weapons. Now I'm gonna save the ship, and now I can purchase this ship in game. There are currently, I think, 60 ship frames to choose from, about 50 different weapons, and about 25 different modules. This number will increase over time, but those will be shown here in the bottom of your screen. Currently, as you can see, I only have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 different ship frames that I can choose from. I can increase this number by killing enemy units in the game, and then sometimes they'll drop a loot crate. And this loot crate will be displayed as a box floating in space. And on the minimap you'll see a yellow octagon indicating the position on the map. The drop rate, well, I can't tell you what the drop rate is, but yeah, you can collect them there, and it can contain either a ship frame, ship weapon, or a module. If you play the tutorial, then there should be one of those crates right outside your base, and that should give you access to this ship, which is the Sunfish.
New ship constructed.
Then you'll probably know what to look for based on that. About the ship weapon types and armor types. There's currently 4 armor types in the game. These are light, which are indicated by triangles, medium, indicated by circles, and heavy, indicated by squares. The weapon type determines how much damage they receive from each type of weapon. So if you have a ship that has light armor and is being hit by an anti-light weapon, then it deals full damage. If you have a medium ship that's being hit by an anti-light weapon, then it gets reduced damage. And if you have a heavy ship that takes damage from a light weapon, it takes even less damage. How do you know what weapon is good against what? Well, in this weapon list, you can see all sorts of different weapons, and to the right you can see what they're good against. As you can see, the magma cannon is very good against buildings, and there's some other statistics there about the weapons as well. There's 3 different types of weapons, globally speaking. They are projectiles, which can miss because they're physics based, but they deal a lot of damage. Then you have the missiles, which almost always hit, but they can be shot down using laser shields. And you have the beam weapons, which always hit, have longer range, but they deal less damage. There's also some special cases, like the Queller for instance. This is an anti-heavy weapon, and it is projectile, but it deals area of effect suppression damage, which means it just deals AoE heavy damage, but less than single target weapons, obviously, to keep it balanced. Then we also have the shield, the modules, and I think I talked about this in this video earlier on as well. And they're pretty self-explanatory, but they can really affect how the ship functions in the game. Another important topic are the weapon slots. As you can see on, let's say, this destroyer, there's 3 weapon slots at the top, and there's 1 weapon slot in the bottom. This means that if there are targets flying over the ship, they can easily be hit by the top turrets, and vice versa with the bottom turrets. I don't currently have it unlocked, but there's a ship called the Orbital Cruiser, and that only has weapons at the bottom. So what you should do there, what I do, is either put missile turrets in it, because they don't require a firing arc, and they can fire in any direction. Or just put other weapons on there and make them fly over the enemy fleet, so that the targets are almost always below them and they can always fire their weapons. So positioning of your ships actually makes a difference in the turret positioning matters in how you should play with those ships basically. What's important to note is that the default fleet that you saw earlier before I changed this ship is actually not underpowered compared to late game fleets. So if you have a player who has put 100 hours in the game, his fleet should be equally strong as that of a player who just started out. The difference is that the player who has spent a lot of time in a game and unlocked a lot of stuff has a lot more options to work with. For instance, they have a repair cruiser, they know how to use the beacon ship more efficiently, they have ships that either cost more metal or more power and can choose modules to modify them accordingly. Basically they have a lot more options to play with, but they shouldn't be stronger, everything should be balanced, so it's definitely not a game in which newbies will always lose from experienced players. They likely still will lose because experienced players have more experience, but it's not, and it should not be, due to the types of weapons on the ships. I think I'm going to show you guys what this ship looks like in game now. So I'll be starting up a game, and I'll be using this destroyer with these 4 plasma cannons. And I think I'll also... Let's see. Yeah, I'll also make a tiny beam frigate. No, Devastator beam frigate. Devastator beam. Alright, so I'll be showing these two in the game in a second.
Ship under attack.
And now that you guys have seen the footage of what they actually look like in game, I'm going to make a new guide on something else pretty soon. And until then, I'm going to work on co-op wave defense, because the wave defense is the most popular game mode right now. And people have requested that they want to play that with friends against an AI opponent. So I'll be looking into this next. That's it for this video. The game is out on Steam. Please share it with your friends. Share it in your Discord communities, Facebook groups, Reddit groups, wherever you think players are that might like the game. Because I could really use it, and it will definitely help me to keep working on this game. Same goes for the Patreon, by the way. Patreons always get the latest features first. And they can join me every Wednesday and play against me in the Multiplayer Wednesday. And then they can also talk to me about what their current feel is in the game and what type of things they would like to see added to the game. That's about it for now. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time.